Hi everyone, welcome to this video on getting started with the Syncfusion TreeView component in a Blazor server application. TreeViews are used to display the hierarchical relationships among data in a tree structure. In this video, I will explain how to add the Syncfusion Blazor TreeView component with the required data to the Blazor server application. After creating the TreeView, I will add features to it like checkboxes, node editing, multiple selection, and drag and drop. You can create a Blazor application using either Visual Studio 2019 or Visual Studio Code. In this video, I will create a server-side Blazor application using Visual Studio 2019. I have installed .NET Core SDK 3.1.3. To follow along with this video, one should have a basic understanding of C#, HTML, and CSS. You can also watch a detailed video on Blazor and Syncfusion controls titled Create a Blazor Server App and Add Syncfusion Blazor Components, which I have shared in the YouTube card. Now, let me create a Blazor project first. I select the Blazor App template, provide the project name, My Blazor Server App, and click Create. Here, the Blazor Server App was selected by default, and I proceed by clicking the Create button. Now, Visual Studio has generated a Blazor Server application. To use Syncfusion Blazor components, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor NuGet package in my application. To do that, I open the NuGet package manager by right-clicking the project file and selecting Manage NuGet packages. Under the Browse tab, I search for the Syncfusion Blazor package. I select it and click the Install button. The installation is completed now. When you check the Dependencies folder and the Packages folder, and you will find the Syncfusion Blazor package added to this application. Next, the Syncfusion Blazor service must be registered in the services container. For that, I open the startup.cs file and use the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Within the configure services method, I make a call to the add Syncfusion Blazor method. This makes Syncfusion Blazor services available within the application. Next, I must register a valid Syncfusion license key. To do so, in the configure method, I call the Syncfusion licensing Syncfusion license provider static method register license. You also need to pass your Syncfusion license key as a string parameter in the register license method. I have done this off stream. Within the pages folder, open the host.cs HTML file. Within the head tag, add the required CSS file to render the Syncfusion Blazor components. In this example, I refer the CSS file from the installed Syncfusion Blazor package. Next, let me add the Syncfusion Blazor TreeView to the index.razor page. To do so, I use the Syncfusion Blazor navigation's namespace. Adding this namespace here will allow me to use the TreeView component markup in this index.razor page. Also, I can import this namespace to the imports.razor page to make it available in all Razor pages within this application. I remove the existing code and type the sftreview tag. Within it, I add the TreeView field settings tag. Let me create its data source in C#. Within the code directive, I create the public class mailItem and add properties ID, parent ID, has subfolders, folder name, and expanded with their respective types. I create a variable of type list for mailItem. Name it my folder and assign a new list of mail item objects. I overwrite the onInitialized method and add items to the my folder list object. Next, within the TreeView field settings tag, I set the data source property with the my folder object that we created. Since the data source property is of generic type, I need to provide the type of the data source object to the TreeView. To do so, in the sftreview tag, I set the property t value and assign the type as mail item. Now the TreeView can understand its data source type is mail item. Now I will explain the structure of flat data used in this example. Here the ID field holds a unique ID to identify each object in this data collection. So in the TreeView field settings tag, I add the property ID and set its value with this ID field name. Next comes the parent ID field with a value that represents to which parent node it belongs. Here, this value points to the ID value of the first object. So, this second object will be considered as a child node of the first object. Now, in the TreeView field settings tag, I will add the parent ID property and assign the value with this parent ID field name. This has subfolders field contains the value that represents whether a node has subnodes or not. Has subfolders has the value true if it is a parent node, otherwise it is a leaf node. So in the TreeView field settings tag, I add the property has children and set its value has subfolders. In this way, the TreeView ensures that the structure of data is self-referential, and then it will start to establish the parent-child relationship. This folder name field contains the value to be displayed in the TreeView. So in the TreeView field settings tag, I add the property text and set its value to folder name. Finally, this expanded field contains the value that represents whether the node should be in an expanded state or in a collapsed state at the runtime of initial rendering. In the TreeView field settings tag, I add the property expanded and set its value to expanded. I save the file. Now I have configured the application with the Syncfusion Blazor TreeView component. Let me run the application. You can see the TreeView with the provided self-referential data source. Also, you can notice that the parent nodes are in expanded state as we provided in the data source. Now, let me show you how to enable checkboxes in Blazor TreeView. The checkbox feature allows you to check more than one node in the TreeView without affecting the UI's appearance. When this is enabled, a checkbox appears before each TreeView node text. If one of the child node is not in a checked state, then the parent node will be in an intermediate state. If all the child nodes are in a checked state, then the parent node's state will also be checked. If a parent node is checked, then all the child nodes' states will also be checked. I will show you how to achieve this in code. In the SF TreeView tag, set the property show checkbox with the value true. Now I save the file and run the application. You can see the TreeView with a checkbox in each node. By default, the checkbox states of parent and child nodes are dependent on each other. If you need an independent checked state for each node, then you can achieve it using the auto-check property. In the SF TreeView tag, let me add the property auto-check and set its value to false. I save the file and run the application. Now I can check each node independently without affecting the parent node's checked state. Next, I will show you how to enable node editing in Blazor TreeView. In the SF TreeView tag, add the property allow editing and set the value to true. I save the file and run the application. In the TreeView, I edit the node promotions by double clicking it. I change the text to start. Next, let me show you how to enable multiple selection. In the SF TreeView tag, add the property allow multiple selection and set the value to true. I save the file and run the application. In the TreeView, I can select multiple nodes by holding the Ctrl key and clicking the leftmost button on the desired nodes. Now I will show you how to enable drag and drop. In the SF TreeView tag, add the property allow drag and drop and set the value to true. I save the file and run the application. In the TreeView, I can drag and drop a node at all levels. You can see the indicator lines and the line icon that represents whether the node needs to be dropped as a sibling. There is the plus and minus icon representing whether the node needs to be dropped as child, and the restrict icon representing that the node cannot be dropped at this node. If you need more information about the Syncfusion Blazor TreeView component, you can refer to our online documentation. A link is provided in the description of this video. Finally, let me summarize the main points. I have explained the steps to add the Syncfusion Blazor TreeView component with data to a Blazor server application. After that, I explain how to enable checkboxes, node editing, multiple selection, and drag and drop features. You can download this fully featured example from the link provided in this video's description. If you found this video useful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to get notifications about new videos. Thanks for watching.